topic is innovation in communication using optical fibers. But before going to innovation, first of all, I will tell you the history of communication. It starts in the year 26 to 37 AD when Roman emperor communicated with each other by sending signaling messages by reflecting sun rays using metal mirrors. In the year 1520, the ships in the sea used to communicate with each other by firing cannon and raising flags. You may heard about telegraph. In telegraph, we were using Morse keys at transmitting and receiving ends. And the Morse keys were connected by using physical conductors like steel wires, aluminium wires or copper wires. We used to press key at one end and generate sound at other end. Then the sound signal were used to pass through physical conductors in the form of dot and dash. Dot means short sound and dash means long sound. For example, if we assign dot dot for English alphabet A at the receiving end, if we receive dot dot, it will be reproduced as A. In this way, signal will be coded at transmitting end and decoded at receiving end. I am going to tell you some facts about telegraph. The first long distance telegraph line was invented by Claude Chappe in the year 1792, and the electric telegraph was proposed and established in the year 1831 by Joseph Henry, whereas the Morse code was developed by Samuel Morse in the year 1836, and he built the first long distance electric telegraph line in the year 1843. Next comes landline telephone, which was invented by Alexander Graham Bell and Thomas A. Watson in the year 1876. Next comes phonograph. Phonograph is a wireless communication system, and which was invented in the year 1877 by Thomas Edison. Next comes radio and television. The first radio station KDKA was established in the year 1920 in Pittsburgh and started its first broadcast. Whereas the first television signal was transmitted by John Logie Weird in the year 1925. Whereas the full-scale commercial television is first broadcast in the year 1947. And the space communication was started in the year 1964, since the first geosynchronous communication satellite was launched in the year 1963. Next comes fax. By using fax, we can transmit data, that is written text, and the images from one end to another by using fax, and it started in the year 1964. Whereas the mobile communication system was first put into operation in 1981, and the first GSM was established and put into operation in 1991. The first SMS was sent by Neil Papworth in the year 1992. Next comes computers and internet. Here come some facts about the computer and internet. The first email was sent in 1965, whereas the first floppy disk was introduced in the year 1971, and the first PC, that is the personal computer, was introduced in the year 1976. The first modem is introduced in the year 1981. The first Microsoft Word software is launched in the year 1983. The IBM laptop is launched in the year 1992. Mosaic graphic web browser is launched in the year 1993. Internet radio broadcast is started in the year 1994. Motorola mobile phone introduced in the year 1996. The first social networking service, 6degree.com, is launched in the year 1997. Peer-to-peer file sharing is launched in the year 1999. Skype video calling software is launched in the year 2003. Facebook is launched in the year 2004. YouTube is launched in 2005. Twitter is launched in 2006. iPhone is launched in 2007. WhatsApp is launched in 2009. Instagram is launched in 2010. and Snapchat is launched in year 2011. Next comes Wide Network. But before telling you about Wide Network, I would like to tell you about the components of communication system. In communication system, we have three components. First one is transmitter, second one is receiver, and third one is media or medium through which information transfers from one end to another end. The example of physical media is wireline system. By using conducting wires or insulating wires. And the second one is space. And in physical media, which is conducting media, we are using twisted pair and coaxial cable. Whereas the example of non-conducting wire or non-conducting media is optical fibers. The twisted pairs are used in telephone communication, whereas the coaxial cable is used in TV communication using cable networking or using dish antennas. Whereas in optical fibers, we are transmitting signals in the form of light. Are you getting how innovation is involved? And due to innovation, communication is upgraded from one communication system to another communication system. Now next comes optical fiber. What is optical fiber? Fiber means threads and optical means light. So it is a system through which the light transfers through the fibers. And the fibers are made up of very thin plastic or glass insulating mediums or dielectric mediums. The thickness of fiber is almost equal to human hair and made up of dielectric or insulating medium which we obtain from silica, and silica is available from sand. And sand is available in huge quantity. The fibers which are used for optical communication are made up of either from plastic or from glass, which are transparent dielectric, and light propagates through these dielectric. And as we know, the speed of light in vacuum is 3×10⁸ meter per second, but it is almost 3×10⁵ meter per second. Therefore, speed of propagation of light is very high in optical fibers as compared to conducting wires. Now, the principle which we are using in optical fibers is total internal reflection. What is total internal reflection? When a ray of light travels from a denser to rarer medium such that the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, the ray reflects back into the same medium. This phenomenon is called total internal reflection. And in optical fibers, the rays undergoes repeated total number of reflections until it emerges out of the other end. In optical fibers, the innermost part is core, which is a highly dense medium or whose refractive index is very high as compared to the outer medium, which is known as cladding, which is also made up of plastic or glass fiber, but its refractive index is less. That's why the ray reflects inwards and it remains inside the core. Optical fiber is used by many telecommunication companies to transmit telephone signals, internet communication, and cable television signals. Here are some components of optical fiber communication system: information source, optical source, electrical source, optical fiber cable, optical detector, electrical receiver, and destination. The information source may be microphone or camera or keyboard, whereas the optical source is used to convert electrical signals into light signals. An example of optical source is LED or laser. The electrical source is used to boost the light signals, whereas the optical fiber acts as a medium which is used to transmit the light signals from the transmitting end to the receiving end. Whereas the other three components, which are optical detector, electrical receiver, and destination, form the receiver. The optical detector converts light back into electrical signal, whereas electrical receiver is used to demodulate and amplify the signals, and destination is maybe the speaker or monitor or the LED or LCD. And there may be some other advantages of optical fibers, since it is available in huge quantity, therefore it is very cheap, and since speed of light is very high, therefore the data rate is very high, and this is all about. Thank you.